What's up, YouTube? We're going to be reviewing the games from Week 6, so let's start it off with Memphis and Salt Lake City. Josh Woodrum played an excellent game. We've been, kind of waiting for more consistency from Woodrum. Last week, he had a lot of turnovers. This week, he had 2 touchdowns and 1 turnover. The defense for Salt Lake City was pretty good. They let up a couple runs, a couple of big plays, but for the most part, they were dominant. I mean, 6 sacks tells you the story. Carter Schultz had 2, and we've seen him a lot this year, and I think we're going to keep seeing him. Also, as you see here, Nick Truesdale has emerged. He's basically, like, watching the game, the announcers are saying he's basically not even a tight end at this point. He is so good and so quick. He's like one of those NFL tight ends that is basically a receiver. But still, Nick Truesdale is a big part of this offense, and I think they're using him well, and I think the Stallions have something going. You know, they've lost a lot of close games, and they can get right back into this. Memphis, on the other hand, they're in a tough position. They had a hard fight in the beginning of this game, losing their starting quarterback, but Johnny Manziel is coming in, and it's coming onto this team, so we could see a different Memphis offense. You know, Johnny Manziel is a very good runner. He brings the dual threat to the table, so we could see a very different team later in the year when Johnny Manziel, maybe next week, I don't know what their plans are for starting him, but possibly Johnny Manziel could open up this offense and help Memphis. Alright guys, the next game we had on Saturday was Orlando and Arizona. Talk about a game of inches. This one came down to the wire, and for good reason. These two teams came to play. We're going to first talk about Arizona and how well they played. One thing you'll notice, Steven Johnson at linebacker makes an immediate difference. He's been injured the past couple of weeks, and he comes on and he has a game-changing interception. That's Garrett Gilbert's first interception of the year. And, you know, Steven Johnson came in, made a play. This defense came to play, holding Orlando to only 17 points. That's crazy. John Wolford had an incredible game, 16 for 27. Threw about 60%, 162 yards and a touchdown. The main thing for him was no turnovers, just playing consistently. Also, you see there, you got Tim Cook, Jarrell Presley, and Justin Stockton. Each running back, 3 running backs, had over 10 rushes. So, you know, things are going well when that's happening. Rashad Ross and Richard Mullaney were playing very well. Rashad Ross playing through an injury, it looked like, and he made some big-time plays. How about the kicker, Nick Folk? 2 field goals. He had a 55-yarder. Good for him. Good for the kickers in this league. Orlando, Garrett Gilbert didn't play a horrible game, but it wasn't what he's used to seeing. 2 touchdowns and a pick. Throwing for 47%. He had 268 yards, so it wasn't terrible, but he had an interception that was pretty bad. He almost threw another one. Running back Dernis Johnson and Deron Smith, they both had decent run games, but not great. This defense just did not let them run like they have been able to all year. You got to see Jalen Marshall, Charles Johnson, they both had good games. I think they both had touchdowns. Orlando had no sacks and no turnovers, so, you know, basically, the offenses are getting a lot better, and it's becoming harder for the defenses. So, just an interesting thing to note, and this came down to the wire, a 10-second runoff as you're watching here. I mean, Orlando just got the bad end of that game, just like Arizona got the bad end of last week. In the Alliance, anybody can beat anybody, and that's why this league is great. Now we'll switch to a game that was not so great, pretty much lopsided. San Antonio dominated Atlanta from the start, forcing multiple turnovers, and also Atlanta didn't really force any turnovers, so that definitely helps. We'll talk about San Antonio first. Logan Woodside came in, he played a pretty good game, had 2 touchdowns, 73.9% on that completion percentage, so that's good, 17 for 23. I mean, he was playing well. Kenneth Farrow and Trey Williams basically split the carries. I mean, Farrow had 3 more carries, but you know, there wasn't much to do for the offense when this defense was forcing so many turnovers. We also got to see a kick return for a touchdown. That was exciting. We'll talk about Atlanta now. Now, Atlanta was just destroyed. I mean, not much other things to say about this game. Sorry, Legends fans, but Aaron Murray threw 3 interceptions. That is never good. The run game never really got going. The defense, they had 2 sacks, no turnovers. I mean, the final score was 37-6, so not much to talk about in this game. The final game of Week 6 was possibly the most exciting. It went down to the wire. Birmingham at San Diego. Let's start off with Birmingham. Talk about Luis Perez, who came in. He was the starter last week and every week before that. Came in for Keith Price, who took over his job. Keith Price got injured after he was moving the offense on like the first drive. And Luis Perez came in, threw touchdowns. He threw 3 touchdowns. 2 picks. He had a pretty good game, 359 yards passing. See here, he has a couple big breakout plays that let this offense breathe. Trent Richardson was just very physical, making the plays when they needed him to. He got a touchdown on the ground and a touchdown through the air. So he is also still leading the league in touchdowns. LaDainian Washington, as I spoke about him, he had an incredible game. Quentin Patton had 8 catches, so he got a lot of action. You know, Jamar Summers, Max Redfield, all those guys in that secondary made big plays. The only knock on Luis Perez is he made some careless passes. As you see there, he had some passes that were just not smart. He could have easily had like 4 interceptions, but then he made throws like those. So, you know, he got a little bit of both in this game. San Diego, on the other hand, they played pretty well. Mike Mercovici had to make a lot of plays because the run game was just not going. You know, and you gotta expect that with Birmingham's defense. They're very good. Mercovici turned the ball over twice, but he had 3 passing touchdowns. We got to see Dontez Ford have some great action. He had 3 catches, 182 yards. So that's always good. He didn't find the end zone, but Watson found the end zone. Owusu found the end zone, and Johnson, the tight end, who... I think Johnson's had a touchdown before this game, if I'm not mistaken, or maybe that was a different tight end on the fleet, but this game did come down to the wire, and lots of explosive plays. Lots of these teams, you know, didn't have great chemistry coming into the year because these offenses only had 30 days to prepare with each other. So now we're starting to see the offenses get a lot better. And as you saw there, Nick Novak's field goal won the game. The Iron offense is now on a roll. Let's see if they can keep it going. And for the Fleet, they just need to turn it over less and get that running game going. All right, YouTube, I will be traveling this week, but I'm going to get videos out for you. So don't worry, I'll be in Arizona for the Arizona game against the Fleet. I'm excited for that. Make sure to like, subscribe, and comment what type of videos you want to see this week.